Now that we know what Google Drive within Google Classroom is, let's move on to using the tools that we could use to teach our students and also check for their understanding. Now we are in the class that we had created earlier. Let me create the Google Meet link for the live class now. You can see the Generate Meet Link option here. Clicking on the link will auto-generate a Google Meet link for me. And I can make the Meet link visible to students maybe 5 minutes before my live lesson begins. Let's make it not visible for now. When I go back to the stream section, I will see the link here, and this icon tells me that the students can still not see it. I can change that 5 minutes before my class by clicking on the settings option and enabling this. It's also safe to make it visible to my students earlier, because the students will not be able to enter the Meet class unless I am present in it. So it's entirely up to each one of us. And as we have seen before, there are plenty of things we could do with Google Meet. We could share our screen to show beautiful presentations, or we could also use the chat feature to engage with our students and so on. Now we're just left with material we need to add for students that they could view after my live class, and of course checking for their understanding. Let's go back to the Google Classroom page and then to the classwork section. I can then move on to clicking on Create and then Material. Then I will enter the appropriate title and the description. To add files, I will click on Google Drive and then select more than one file at once. I will simply click on Control, hold the key, and select the files we want to import and then click on Add. I can see the three post-class files here. What else can I do for my students? Well, I could also add a link to a reliable website. And guess what? I have an option to also add a YouTube link by searching for a good video. We are now ready with all the material our students need. Within material, I need to be sure about two things. One, it should belong to the relevant topic. And second, as the material should be accessible only after my live lecture, I will schedule the post at a time after my live lecture. So I will schedule it on this day at 11 a.m. My students will not be able to see this until the scheduled date. Now, after my live class, how do I know for sure if my students have really understood the concepts? It's very easy. I can click on the Classwork tab and then on Create. I will then pick from any of the three options here. I could choose a long form assignment or a graded assignment, or I could also choose to ask just a single question to my students. Let's assume I gave my students a quiz assignment which had 5 questions, with each question worth 2 points. After my students have attempted the quiz, I also get the summary of the quizzes taken in my class by clicking on the grade section here. Clicking on any of the quiz links here will give me a detailed summary of the scores. Here I can see that all my students have turned their assignments in. If it's a quiz assignment, then I will make sure I don't forget to import grades so that the scores are recorded. I can now see that all the students have got their scores. And after this is done, I will select all students and return the scores to them by clicking here. They will then be notified of their scores. Here I can see that all my students have been graded. That's how easy it is to replicate your school classroom on Google Classroom. It's seamless. It helps you teach, collaborate, communicate, and organize assessments in a paperless way. Happy teaching!